Okay, today I'm going to make a flow painting using 5 different colors. You can use any acrylic paint, but I use the paint sample colors from Sherwin-Williams because they have vibrant colors. So I just started by pouring some paint from the bucket into my cups. Then you put in golden medium. This is gloss. You'll want to put some of this medium in the paint before you mix it with water. Help the paint to break down just a little bit so that it can interact, somewhat mixing, somewhat repelling. You can use different kinds of pouring mediums. I just like the golden. It seems to work the best to create cells. And I'll show you, hopefully, what that means when I pour the paint. And then I mix water with the paint to get a good pouring consistency, and I'll show you what that looks like. The thing about viscosity, if you have one that's quite thin, it will tend to disappear underneath all the other paints, so you just won't get that color participating. And so you try and get the paints all about the same runniness, if you will. And if you get it too runny, they tend to overmix. So you'll see this is a good viscosity right here. Usually the stick won't stand up by itself if you have it about right. So I just use a Blaster silicone lubricant. Treadmill lubricant works well. It's 100% silicone is what it's supposed to work the best. But I have other silicone that's not 100% that works okay as well. So I usually just do, you know, a couple of sprays. And you don't want to, you know, kind of stir it around and really agitate it. You just want to stir it in. And again, I am not a chemist. But supposedly when you pour it on the canvas, the silicone that's trapped in the acrylic paint, when it's moved around or when it's heated, will kind of come to the surface in bubble form and escape. So again, you want to make sure you kind of have it where you want it. Mix it. And silicone, less is more. I started out by dumping a bunch in and it didn't do anything, and I was really confused by that. And it turns out the less I use, the better result I got, so that's nice. Okay, now we're getting ready to pour here. So you can see it's already mixed. Now, if I wanted to create some more cells, like I usually like to do just a few, you know, make some smaller cells. And then once you start to move this paint around, those cells will actually grow to gigantic size, and it looks cool. Okay, here we go. Now you can see, you move it. So I kind of like that. I don't want to move that off the canvas. Move it slowly. Sometimes you can keep some of these bigger cells intact. Awesome. I'm gonna move that completely off, and then I'm gonna move this so that I don't have again that center line, so that line is not right down the middle. And then I moved. I can actually move this side, hopefully. Nope. So it depends on how liquid your paint is. I'm gonna actually quickly mix a little more paint so I can pour the white pieces. And then in this case, since I'm not like flipping it, I'm kind of pouring it on, I'm gonna do a little mix here. See, it's moving quickly, so I'm gonna be careful here that I don't move some of this stuff off that I like. The other thing is if you move it around too much, again, it will mix and become muddy.